Are you able to say a little bit about, and we will of course deepen it as we go on, what is different about sexual grounding therapy? Like, what is it?
Yeah, when you compare sexual grounding with other forms of therapy or therapeutic approaches, the first thing is that I am very explicit over the whole human body, including the genital area. Mm-hmm. And that means that the body is natural for me. The body has a communicating function. It has an existence function. So when you think about your body, you must have the feeling that you really are allowed to exist in your whole body. And it looks like, for me, that means it was also in my case, that I had not always the feeling that I was allowed to exist in every part of my body. Mm-hmm. So for me then, in therapy, I said, I have to be more and more explicit about this, mm-hmm. because it is difficult to be explicit about it, and people are on the look for it, mm-hmm. to get real and open relationships. So that was one what was not the same as what happening in every therapy, because mm-hmm. when I followed my therapeutic education, mm-hmm. mostly when the therapeutic issues came to the front of where a part of the education, then it was, for me, looking from my point of view, superficial, and mostly at the end of a course. Mm-hmm. So I was
for 2 hours.
Yeah, I was always asking myself, what is this? Because it's a very important thing. We all come from this, even the therapist who was working with me. Yep. And we had a sexual issue on the table, which we had to approach later as a professional. And then it was short in relation to the rest. It looks like this part was not on a therapeutic level, on an approach level, not important enough for me. And I said, how is this possible? So I said, okay, that is a signal for me. When I'm going to work as a professional, I will put that in the front. Mm-hmm. It's not that it had to be in the front, but I think it's better to put it in the front and to frame it in, and to frame it in a relationship and in the total body.
Mm-hmm. So to give an example of that, I think if you look at a lot of Alexander Lowen's writings about bioenergetics, he does mention sex.
Yes.
And he mentioned sexual energy, and certainly Reich did, mm-hmm. but it's very generalized. So he will talk about tensions in the pelvis, mm-hmm. and how we release those tensions. And I don't know whether you did all those exercises which were designed to release the mm-hmm. pelvic tension, but no mention of genitals.
Yeah.
Genitals do not come into it.
Yeah, I recognize that experience. And I remember when I was in courses of bioenergetics, one of my body therapeutic education, after my study as a psychologist, then I thought I had an intention to talk to Lowen about this, but unfortunately the time that we find to visit him, he was ill, and later there was no opportunity to do it anymore. Mm-hmm. Looking back, I regret it a little, because I wanted to put that real thing on the table. He had the aim and he had the idea to approach the whole body.
Yes.
He did a lot of very good work, sure. but just like as you said, the genitals as part of the whole body did not get that attention which, according to my opinion, is necessary.